Trick is, the ultraviolet rays pierce the clouds, so even on a dreary day, the sun is purifying your water. That means no matter what happens, you can get your water clean with a simple method. That's it. Now you've got one simple method to add to your arsenal. All you've got to do now is grab a few more. The problem is, no one has any reasonable ideas on how to keep clean drinking water flowing to your home.
Well, that's not exactly true. Some of the people that I'm going to be having on this next week, and you will be able to get all of my shows on freeamerican.com. You'll be able to download them off of Blog Talk Radio, Clayton Douglas. And just go to freeamerican.com and click on the name of the guest here. I will be having some guests on. I was just at a conference call yesterday. And all of the things that I have talked about, all of the things that I've had on here, that I've got up on my site, that I've got up on my Facebook. Go to my Facebook site, FreeAmerican69. Go to my YouTube site, FreeAmerican69. And the new technology as it comes out, that's going in the magazines that I'm putting out every 2 weeks. This last issue of the magazine had a story about graphene. Graphene is a new substance that's stronger than steel, thinner than the human hair, and conducts electricity better than any of the chips that they've got out now. They've got it The inventors of this, discoverers of this substance, were awarded the Nobel Prize. They were awarded the Nobel Prize for the discovery of graphene. And they predict, as you can read in the January 1st issue of the Free American, they predict it will change our society more than ever, more than anything before. It's like the discovery of copper, start of the Bronze Age, and the discovery of the creation of steel revolutionized, brought on the Industrial Revolution. So it's and it's just one. Now, Tesla Motors has done a has come out with an electric car, and the electric cars, they've just discovered something that I thought of a long time ago. I'm not a mechanic. I'm not an inventor. I'm a reporter. But it occurred to me, if our cars, when we're driving down the street, our tires are rolling. Why not use that motion of those tires to generate electricity? Well, now somebody's come out with that. Somebody's got a wheel that has a generator inside it. And so as it's rolling, as it's going down the street, it's generating its own electricity. So the concept of an electric car, which was founded almost 100 years ago, but of course the oil companies didn't want you to have that. The oil companies didn't want you to have hemp. The chemical companies didn't want you to have hemp. It's so what's the answer? What's the answer? Well, the Noah's Ark project is taking all of that into consideration. And they are they do have a plan for it. And their plan covers just about everything that I've talked about here. Everything. Let's share some of that with you. Matter of fact, I've got it up here. Operation GreenFire is what he talks about. The way it opens up, and I've got the links up on my website. He's talking about creating the largest peacetime project in American history, built by an all-veteran army. Now, first of all, this whole plan, using the veterans, supporting the veterans, giving the veterans jobs, giving them a place to live. And I've spoken with him about the idea that I came up with in libertyvillages.org of using teepees. You can get a teepee for $5,000. One of my guests I had just added on two or three days ago, David Sneakus. He's the one that turned me on to this project, to this gentleman, who will be on my show later. Blog Talk Radio, for sure. And he lived in a teepee in Alaska. I've got pictures of teepees under the northern lights. He said he was perfectly comfortable in it. Freezing weather, cold climate. And he was perfectly comfortable in this teepee. So, for this Operation GreenFire, we would be using teepees as temporary structures for the veterans while they're building these houses. The GreenFire SuperHome. Now, at the conference call, one of the people participating in the conference call got a little upset. Well, it's too big. You want to? He foresees this. The gentleman's name is Noah, and he foresees this. These SuperHomes as being very similar to the old brick buildings in downtown and all the small towns across America. And I've told you that the Liberty Villages and a new concept, we settled this whole country with them. We settled the whole country with them. We had the downtown section. People were living upstairs. They had their businesses downstairs. And this is the way Noah saw this project to begin with, initially. He's been working on it for over 35 years. And he sees this as his Noah's Ark villages. He says it will mirror the familiar architecture of small towns all across America. We call our architecture Main Street USA. He says 30 years of experience in innovative construction techniques has given us the ability to build high-quality GreenFire SuperHome very fast, and with the Veterans Green Bank, again, this is stuff that we're talking about, we're talking about doing the financing, and one of the people that were on there, well, you got to have long-term financing. Well, we don't necessarily want to use the Federal Reserve. We don't want to use, get the government involved in this. And there are things like our credits that we can use. That's our credits is our project of good, common good financing. That's a 501c3 nonprofit corporation who envision a society in which communities everywhere gather to decide for themselves what their financial priorities should be. They say our mission is to design and create the framework for that new economy by integrating a fast-growing mutual credit system with a new type of bank account, creating community-centered decision-making, money creation, innovation, cooperation, and economic justice. And to learn more about their operation, their organization, you can go to commongoodfinance.org. Now, this the people that have created this, and keep in mind, this alternative money system has already been in existence for at least 20 years in a little place called Ithaca, New York. They created Ithaca Hours. It will gather, it will, they created the Ithaca Hours. And it works. It's worked for 20 years. Worked for 20 years in Ithaca, New York. What this gentleman has done, what Noah's done, is to put it all together. First of all, the veterans. First of all, the veterans is the important thing. The veterans, more, I think it's a national tragedy that more of my brothers that went to Vietnam, I didn't have to go. I volunteered for it. But they more of them have killed themselves since they got home than were killed by the Vietnamese. And post-traumatic stress syndrome, that may be another thing. I call it a conscience. I think they're getting upset about this. And the Gulf of Tonkin incident never happened. So, just like 9/11, they created something to take us to war. Because the banks make money on both sides. So, what we got to do is eliminate the banks. What we got to do is support the veterans. And we still got our food and water that's a problem here. In Colorado, you can grow grass there now, you can grow hemp there now, you can grow a pot, but you can't trap rainwater off of your roof. Puh. Why does that happen? Why is that happening? Well, they don't want you. They want you drinking that fluoridated water. The fluoride actually dumbs you down. The fluoride, you're drinking that tap water. If you don't use reverse osmosis, you don't have filter. And by the way, now we got radiation floating over here from Fukushima. That's polluting your water, too. But that can be removed. I've got up on my website, freeamerican.com, I've got a water filtration system that you can hook up, and it'll take the filter out, it'll take the fluoride out, it'll take the radiation out. It'll eliminate the radiation. And that happened course, this gentleman that I just played his little video, talking video, it you can actually filter your water by letting the ultraviolet rays, put it in a filter, get the heavy stuff out of it with a cloth, pour it into a plastic, clear plastic Coke bottle, and set it out in the sun, and the ultraviolet rays, all the ultraviolet rays clean your water. But you can also get the, if you don't want to do it that way, you can do it that way. You can clean it up. But this village concept, now, these buildings, if you've got a business and you need that square foot, that'll work. He has agreed with me that using the teepees to set these up on farms, they've got 400 acres in Florida lined up. They've got, they'll be closing on that in March. They've got land in Texas lined up. They've got land, I believe, in Tennessee lined up. But we'll have more information on that up on my website, freeamerican.com, very shortly, when I have Noah on here. Now, Noah's got 30 years' experience in innovative construction technology that has given him the ability to build high-quality GreenFire SuperHome very fast. This Veterans Green Bank they're trying to set up right now, and we'll be talking, I'll be talking with Charles Collins a little bit later about that. They're also, we've also suggested they contact the Sioux in North Dakota that started their own bank. He thinks by lowering the interest rate that we can make these homes financially available to millions of Americans. But if we intend to build a million homes by the end of this decade, we need a million building lots, and finding a million lots ready to build on became a nightmare in red tape. The village solution was the third major solution behind the SuperHome and the development of the Veterans Green Banks. That means that makes building 1 million GreenFire SuperHomes by the end of this decade possible. This GreenFire SuperHome, they're using concrete construction, and I've suggested that they consider hempcrete. Up on my Facebook site, Free American 69, I've got a little 3-minute video of a couple in North Carolina that built their home, quite a large home, using this hempcrete, and it's got better insulation, better structural integrity than a normal concrete. So I've suggested that they consider this, especially considering that now we have the ability to get hemp from Colorado. In the SuperHomes construction, every home would have what I had in New Mexico, in my little post office there in New Mexico. I had a water collection tank. Theirs are larger, they're looking at about 3,000 gallons to gather the rainwater and filter it and process it. They're looking to insulate the homes better. If you really think about it, the little box houses, the little wood box houses, even the brick box houses that you get, they aren't very energy efficient. They leak, your water heater leaks energy, not very efficient. These super homes need no water, no sewer or electrical lines, and thus can be built anywhere. As can the Noah's Ark Global Villages. I've also suggested that he lose the term global and use Liberty Villages, which because global right now has a negative connotation. But this process is pretty exclusive with Noah's Ark Global Villages, and that's you can check that out at projectnoahsark.com. He said the downtown section of most American homes, built from 1880 to 1938, were in most cases two-story brick buildings with stores on the first floor and the owner's home on the second floor. Like the, he's got a picture of downtown Knoxville. In a time before automobiles, it was convenient and economical to have businesses and homes in the same place. Same is true for us. The GreenFire SuperHomes are built vertically instead of horizontally. This gives our village the authentic, historic look and feel and functionality of a pre-1938 town. The way Noah sees it is each global village will be made up of 40 GreenFire SuperHomes arranged around a central village square. The central village square is huge, 300 by 600 feet, about the size of 4 football fields. It is the centerpiece of the village and will serve many functions. A twice weekly farmer's market will become a ready outlet for produce from owners' rooftop greenhouses, as well as the traditional 40-acre village farm. Natural setting for music festivals and concerts, as well as environmental events such as Earth Day, environmental expos, national holiday celebrations, etc. The revenue generated from these events becomes part of the Village Association Fund that will pay for village farm community services and serve to fund many different organizations and services, both for the village farm community as a whole, as well as charities selected by the village farm. Thus, the village farm is not only self-contained and sustainable in electricity, water, and food, but is also financially self-sustaining. Now, let's see if we can get more on the super home that he envisions. Now, I believe also you should have the opportunity. Again, it's the energy efficiency and the fact that solar, he's doing exactly what I have suggested, that the solar be put on the roof, the water's in a holding tank in the basement, the roofs also contain the gardens, greenhouses on the roof to house the gardens, and if you generate your own energy from your home and you grow your own food, then you don't need the government or the banks for nothing. Don't need anything else. You know, you people in the chat room are really ignorant people. You make fun of everything, every good idea. People have spent thousands of hours, hundreds of hours on this. And this will be my last show on Wolf Spirit Radio because all of you are fucking idiots. You attack my friends. You attack the people that want to listen to me. You attack everything that anybody says. You're nothing but slime. You're nothing but slime. You got 10 listeners on here, and you're all fucking idiots. I'm not going to be on Wolf Spirit Radio anymore. This will be my last show. You can kiss my ass, all of you. You're ignorant motherfuckers. I got no desire to be on a radio station that's run like this, that allows this shit going on. I ain't gonna do it. Now they hung up on me. Son of a bitch. All right. Well, my radio station just disconnected. Good. Good. I will be on Blog Talk Radio. Sorry about the foul language. I will be on Blog Talk Radio from now on. Let me see if I can get my Crusade Radio back up here. Let's see if we can get that on. Again, my apologies. I just saw so much crap on their chat room. I won't deal with that anymore. I will not deal with that anymore. So let me bring Crusade back up. And we'll get this back started. They cut off my Crusade line here, so let's see if we can get that back. All right. Sorry about that. We were disconnected because I just went on a rant against Wolf Spirit Radio. There's nothing in the chat room. You got five people in the chat room and they're only there to try to make fun of our ideas, make fun of what we're doing. So I will be on Crusade Radio from now on. I'll be on Blog Talk Radio, but I won't be on Wolf Spirit anymore. To hell with them. To hell with them. It's nothing else. And he was threatening me anyway. I couldn't even respond to anything anybody said about me without being threatened by this asshole. So we ain't doing that no more. I ain't playing those kind of games. Nobody controls what I talk about, what I say, and where I say it. They don't do this. So let's finish this story about these GreenFire SuperHomes. All of this is up on freeamerican.com. And if you want to support me, then you can go to freeamerican.com. You can make a donation. And click on any of the donate buttons. If you want to, keep in mind, this is what I put up with. Every, oh, Clay's talking about the Jews again. Every time I go to Austin, Tucson, the Jews come in the room. You don't know they're Jews. They could be just regular people. And frankly, I've never asked anybody, oh, are you Jewish? I don't care who your grandmother slept with. I don't care what you do. If you want to work together and present something, instead of being a slug, you know, an insulting slug, I don't want to be around you. I don't want you in my groups. I don't want you. I don't want to even have to look at you. This is what they do. I came out with my book on Mystery Babylon that has a whole Operation Watchtower, the drug smuggling operation by the Israelis. Names the Israelis who were involved in this, who handled Noriega, who picked up the cocaine, put it on Barry Seal's plane, and flew it up to Bill Clinton and Arkansas, a little place called Mena. All that's in my book, Mystery Babylon. You can get it for $10 right now up in shop.fearamerican.com or amazon.com. I am not a novice here. I do this. I worked with presidential candidates. Oh, that's another thing. You know, Jesse Ventura is talking about running for president. But and as soon as my friend David Koss said anything about Jesse Ventura, they tried to kick him off the website. Jesse, if Jesse ran for president and won, like he did when he ran for governor as an independent, he'd be the first president since Washington that wasn't a member of a political party. Now, back to these ceramic. They're ceramic superfire concrete home. And now, again, I'm suggesting that Noah use hempcrete to build these things. This system was designed to be built by veterans, use the skills very similar to what they use in the military. Close military style, teamwork, heavy equipment, close logistics support, communications and computer skills. Easy and fast to install, the superstructure does several things. First, it creates a solid, tight, highly insulated shell around the home with a world-leading thermal efficiency, 95% better than the standard wooden home. In other words, these super homes need only 5% of the energy to heat or cool. Second, through forensic engineering, we have discovered that only one type of home survives all hurricanes, tornadoes, floods, and wildfires. We use that engineering in our super homes. And third, this type of system makes it easy and inexpensive to create our T-Bear system, as well as our 15,000-gallon rainwater storage tank, both of which are located in our the foundation system. This system is a world first, invented and developed and tested exclusively by our founder over the last 35 years. And their Spark system, that is solar power and rainwater canopy, as an elegant solution that accomplishes multiple tasks. First, it is a 2,500 square foot solar array generating 3 to 4 times the electricity needed by the home, as well as providing 1,200 square feet of greenhouse glass. Second, by containing the solar array in glass, we can capture the heat that is otherwise lost from the solar arrays. We get 800 gallons of hot water free. The leftover hot air is used in the T-Bear system, as well as in multiple other ways. Third, the rainwater harvesting system is far, far more than just a rain barrel under a downspout. It is a sophisticated, pure harvesting system that allows the water in the first flush in a cloud burst to be diverted into the greenhouse containers. The cleaner secondary rainwater is filtered and goes into the 1200 gallon storage tank. SPARC is a world first on several levels. It was invented and developed by Noah West. And then these homes would be the T-Bear, have the T-Bear system. T-Bear, that is the thermal battery and electrostatic air regeneration system. Another elegant solution. It makes use of thermodynamics to both heat and cool the home without either fossil fuels or solar energy. The theory is simple. It gets warm in the day and cool at night, dynamically averaging day and night temperatures through the use of large thermal masses in specially highly insulated chambers, provides heat at night and coolness in the day. Noah began developing this system in 1979 and perfected it to the point where he was able to heat or cool homes for months nearly energy free. And a second purpose for T-Bark, T-B-A-R-C, thermal battery and electrostatic air regeneration, is the air regeneration. Electrostatic charging of air particles is not new, but previous systems had serious problems. Positively charging air makes the particles in the air stick to negatively charged surfaces. This cleans the air, but creates messy surfaces. T-Bear uses a special chamber of common river rocks covered in special salt crystals that both attract the particles and neutralize bacteria, virus, mold, and even odors, creating an interior environment that is 99.99% pure and filter-free for life. T-Bear is another world first invented and developed by our founder. There are over 150 patents in process in the GreenFire SuperHome, including a three-story solar energy elevator, nearly zero energy refrigerators and walk-in freezers, the Circle of Life kitchen, air curtain stoves, dryers, run on solar energy heat, focused sunlight, overhead lighting, interior lighting, friendly fire, rooftop fire pits, and our proprietary liquid composting micro sewage plant, and our zero pollution technologies, and many more. This is the technology these idiots in wolf spirit were laughing about, making fun of. Anything that, and this is the problem we've got. I frankly don't know if these people have been dumbed down by fluoride, if they've been paid to come in and try to create problems, or maybe they've just been drinking too much fluoride. Maybe they're doing drugs. I don't know. Maybe they're doing pharmaceuticals. I don't know what's wrong with people. But I'm glad to see them gone. Now, let's also talk about this. The Noah's Ark Farms. The farmer solution can make our goal a build. Now, this is what they're doing. They've gone after the farmers, and they don't want you to grow hemp. They don't want you to renew your soil. They use these pesticides, do this, do that. Use the GMO modified seeds. The attack is on our food supply. This system, this Noah's Ark GreenFire system, is a way to counter that. Once a Noah's Ark Global Village has been designed and the site selected by the veteran homeowners along with the civilian village shop owners, minimum of 40 acres will buy the land for the villagers. We will then select the organic farmer from our registered members. These farmers may or may not be veterans. Hopefully this farmer will be from the local area. Once a farmer is selected, we will sign a long-term contract with him and have him start developing the village's pure organic community farm. The money spent by developers on utilities like electric, water, sewer, roads, golf courses, clubhouses, and other elaborate facilities we are spending on developing organic soil, composting facilities, livestock pens, milking barns, energy-efficient farming equipment, etc. The farmer will not pay mortgages or taxes or buy the farm machinery in order to develop this land as a pure organic farm. This very low overhead will maximize his profits as he sells his produce in the twice weekly farmers market in the village square and reduce his financial risk to near zero. The village square and the farmers market held there serve as a ready, convenient, and profitable market for the farmer. Now, this has also been done in Oklahoma, folks. I have information up there, the Oklahoma Food Co-op. You can go on the internet and find it. Oklahoma Food Co-op. They put the farmers in connection with the, they put the farmers in connection with the folks in the city. And probably once a week or certain times, they go into the village square, the courthouse, and fill the orders. So, something very similar to this would work with these global villages and the global village farm. And by opening up this community, letting people from the outside come in and see what you're doing, I believe these villages, not global villages, but liberty villages, will very quickly become self-financing. The technology is duplicable. People can do it all over the country. Now, Noah said the cost of farmland is inexpensive outside cities compared to buying lots in inexpensive established developments, often only $5,000 to $25,000 per acre compared to development lots costing $50,000 to several hundred thousand. We pass these savings on to the homeowners. We have no utility costs, no cost for golf courses, clubhouses, or elaborate roads. Without county impact costs, permitting is simpler, saving time and money. This is the organic farm. Now, let's talk about this green bank. The middle class in American history began when the returning World War II GIs took advantage of the newly created GI Bill. This bill gave the greatest generation of GIs access to low-cost housing and education and resulted in millions of homes and thousands of engineering and technology degrees. The economic and technological boom that this GI Bill created lasted for the better part of 30 years, including the space race of the 60s and 70s. It's one of the most successful socio-economic experiments in American history. The Veterans Green Bank is a citizen version of the GI Bill. It calls for the creation of a new kind of bank, a public bank, a federally chartered, nonprofit, affirmative action Veterans Green Bank that will borrow money directly from the Federal Reserve, the same as the big banks, but at a rate of 1% for 60 years. And to pass this loan directly through to the veterans owners of the GreenFire SuperHome. Banking at the national and international level is highly complicated, but at its simplest, the Federal Reserve Bank borrows money directly from the government and loans money out to other banks. See, now this is the part. His plan was started over 6 years ago, so he doesn't understand the con that the Federal Reserve is. He is starting to understand that, and we are working on that. But we'll also be looking into the whole comprehensive annual financial report. We'll be looking at that. We will be all right. This chat room's working now. All right. All right, glad you guys can hear me. This green bank, I think it's quite possible to generate our own money, our own funds. We can start a bank. We can do that, and it can be a non-profit bank. So I think we can do that without the Fed. Maybe we can do it with the International Monetary Fund. Maybe we can do it with the BRIC countries. Maybe we can do it early on, because I believe that this system puts the power back into the hands of the people, and it doesn't matter whether the people are Chinese, African, Russian. The Russian people were never our enemy. The whole Cold War was a banker's joke, a banker's plan. Divide and conquer. This is what they always have. This system, this GreenFire Liberty Village system, puts the power back into the hands of the people. And I've told you over and over again, day after day, I've said, look, if you can generate your own energy, grow your own food, grow grass, or grow food instead of grass, then you don't need the government or the banks for nothing. This is what this system does. And the having this built and run by veterans, that shows them the respect and gives them the benefits that they deserve that they're not getting from the VA, that they're not getting from the federal government. What the federal government is doing is spraying our veterans, spraying our soldiers with Agent Orange, giving them depleted uranium to use against our enemies who never done anything. Iran hasn't done anything. Iraq didn't do anything. None of those people were a threat to us. Might have been a threat to Israel because they're a criminal regime. And that was the other thing. Wolf Spirit didn't want me talking about the Jews. I don't want you to talk about Jews. That's because you must be a Jew, you kike motherfucker. So I'm sorry. I don't know what he is. I don't care. I can tell you this. He ain't a super soldier. And everybody in that chat room, with the exception of my friends that are now in the Blog Talk Radio chat room, are nothing but idiots, troublemakers, trolls, what we call trolls. And I should be used to this now. I probably shouldn't get that upset. I probably shouldn't get mad about it. But I do. I do. And they were doing all right for a while. They were doing all right for a while. Nice to see you in the chat room. Nice to see you in the chat room working now. They won't come around, dude. They won't come around here. Gee, guess what? I've been banned from WSR. Guess what? I'm banning WSR. I'm taking everything off. Everything off about Wolf Spirit Radio. I gave them more advertising than they ever got anywhere else. I was more of a draw for them than anyone. I'm losing donations. Well, that's the way the Jews always do. That's the way the Jews always do. Well, you're carrying that Fear American magazine. Well, we're going to tell all of our friends not to shop here anymore. Unless you get rid of it. This is the way they do it. This is the way they do it. This is the way they operate all the time. And I'm simply not putting up with it. I ain't going to put up with it. I will be going there to my website before the whole thing is over, before this show is probably even over. We will no longer have anything about Wolf Spirit on my website. Nothing. They're not the only ones that can ban people. I've been in this battle a long time, folks. And I've got a thing here. I don't tell you anything that ain't true. I don't tell you anything that ain't true. If it's a good idea, I'll listen to everybody. I've got people on my show. That's what I do. I have guests up, so you can talk about anything you want. You know, even Rabbi Ted was better than these assholes. And we're still on Crusade. We're still on Blog Talk Radio. And probably before the weekend is over, I'll be back on another station. I won't be censored. I will talk about anything I want. You want to tell you, if you're on CNN, you can certainly talk about Muslims. And if you're listening to Fear American, I will talk about the Jews who say they're Jews but are not, are of the synagogue of Satan. And by the way, if you're in Wolf Spirit and you want to hear a show, you got to pay for it. If you go to freeamerican.com And by the way, I've got all the links up here about Operation Greenfire, about Liberty Villages. I'll be updating the whole Liberty Village plan here very shortly here. And if you you can make a donation there, you can help out, you can be a part of this. I want veterans to contact me. I want veterans to get a hold of me. And I'm going to be putting this article that I'm working on this weekend. I'll be working on it all weekend. I'm going to be putting that up on Veterans Today. I will put this article up on Veterans Today. This man has an answer. It may not be perfect. It may need some ironing out. You know, I had one guess. My friend V.K. Durham got upset with me because I was reading a letter that Noah wrote to, to President Obama. I mean, you know, maybe for a while there, you voted for him. Somebody voted for him. We voted him in, or they put him in. So, who did that? Wasn't me. It wasn't necessarily him, but he is our president. He actually did come out with one good executive order talking about the resources in rural lands. Resources in rural lands. That was a good executive order. And as I said, I agreed with that. All except the part about, this is why the government has to get involved. This is why, no, we don't need the government. The government needs to stay out of this. We need to run this community by community, county by county. We need to take the counties back over and the cities back over and start looking at the comprehensive annual financial report, see what this money is supporting. And maybe we need to reinstitute, again, even one of the things that B.J. Campbell says that I've got up on my website here. I've got B.J. Campbell saying that we need a three-part plan, neighborhood watch, civilian police review boards, and bring the military into the resistance. This is my way of implementing that third plank on his little three-part platform. And the civilian review boards and the neighborhood watch, that's an integral part of that. That will all be instituted here as we take these over. We establish one of these global villages, one of these Liberty villages, as Noah sees it. And it will be franchisable. It will. We've got the technology. He owns the technology. He has the patents for these energy-saving devices. And all his patents do and all this does is cut out the middleman. Remember I've told you about the whole idea that you know, the government's idea of greening America is to sell the top of that land, lease the top of that land to a bunch of Chinese companies that are going to build windmills that are going to generate the green energy, the pollution-free energy. Then they're going to pipe it down to the power plant down the hill and pipe it through all the lines to you and sell it back to you. They may have to charge you more because they got more hands in their pocket. This is the, by putting the power on your own home, on your roof, whether it's wind, whether it's solar, whether it's a magnetic generator, and having the veterans there to protect your village and to protect your home, and a neighborhood watch, we can make this happen. We can make this happen. And if you don't want to help, good, take a walk. Take a hike, man. We don't need you around. We don't need you around no more. I'd throw. There you are. We got other guests there. I'm glad to see this is all working, and we're going to looking forward to this. This was this whole wolf spirit was a hassle to me anyway. It was a hassle, and hey, Henry, welcome back. Welcome back. Thanks, RJ. Yeah, I think I kind of did in style. I didn't wait to get fired. I don't know. You don't have to fire me. Yeah, a little bit, Henry. Yeah, you missed it a little bit. I went off on him, told him to go to hell, to kiss my ass, among other things. I was probably just a little rude. These people, I'm talking about this thing, they had their little trolls there, their pet trolls. These are the good guys. I don't know, tell them, David, tell them what happened. I don't really know. I saw the last thing from this Dr. No, Bob Dr. No, who did nothing but put down my friends, put down me, put down David. Calling everybody stupid, trying we American, you know, and it just finally hit me long. So and Dave had already threatened to fire me. He had already threatened to fire me. So it's no problem. Yeah, I'll share some of that with you guys. Now we got a chat room that I control, that I can work on. I got five people on this damn thing. Here's what he said. And among other things, and of course then he threatened me too. Let's go with that here. Do I need to look for another station? No, I don't need to look for another station. I got it. I've already got it. And I damn sure don't need Wolf Spirit for nothing. Nothing. It's, let's see, what was the other thing he said? Here, this is Dave trying to kick me out of the chat room. No problem. I'll stay out of the chat room. And already, if you go to freeamerican.com, you'll see that Wolf Spirit ain't mentioned and will never be mentioned again. Ain't going to do it. Ain't going to have the son of a bitch on. Ain't going to listen to this kind of crap from nobody. Nobody. I don't know. You know, people just don't realize I've been doing this a long time. You know, I've been in bike clubs. I've been into the Hells Angels Clubhouse. I've been into the Outlaws Clubhouse. I've been friends. My first club went to the Banditos. And we don't put up with shit from nobody. I won't start a fight, but I'll finish one every time. You always get the first swing with me. They took their best shot, and guess what? Ain't hurt me none. Ain't hurt me none. Won't happen. I've watched them try to kill me. I've watched them try to stop me. And now Wolf Spirit is the latest to line up against me. Yeah, thanks. I don't know what that is. Probably won't go to it. Some Corso information? Oh, okay. What did Corso got to say here? What's that? I'll take a look at that. Now you caught my interest. All right.
That what you're talking about, the Jews. I don't want you. I'm sorry. You know what? I'm talking about Israel. I'm saying about the Jews ain't Jews. As the Bible told us. I mean, this is Jesus. Of course, they don't want to hear about about anything here.
Okay. All right, appreciate sending me that. I don't look at it yet, but I don't care. This is like Dave Corso is like an ex-wife to me now. He's like an ex-wife. I don't talk to him. I don't need to talk to him. He ain't worth a shit. He ain't got the brains to run a business, much less a radio station. So, knock yourself out. You want to listen to a bunch of these people? Go right ahead. We still have people on from Pahrump. I've got a whole little booklet here from a gentleman. Right there in Pahrump. David Lantry, I'll have him back on, and he can give my regards. He sent me this letter and said to all veteran brothers, this is right there in Pahrump, to all veteran brothers and U.S. citizens, who believe the U.S. Constitution is the backbone of freedom in America. If one veteran's constitutional rights are blatantly violated and ignored by a federal court, then every veteran that has given up a part or all of his life for the freedom of the United States since the beginning has just been insulted, slapped, and spit on by the very recent past by a U.S. District Court and judge. I have in my possession all the documents to prove my story and would love to collaborate with a responsible writer to get this alive story before the public. If you've been looking for one explosive story to bring along, then please pay attention. This story was supported from A to Z by statements, witnesses, and court transcripts. Professional people, doctors, psychiatrists have urged me to contact a writer and tell my story. Well, guess what? You contacted a writer. You contacted a damn good writer. And David, I'll be calling you so you can pass my message on to Dave Corso. Pass my message on to Dave Corso. David Lantry is a 72-year-old disabled veteran, never had a run in the law, been a resident of Nevada since 1965, been a small business owner, a rancher, PRCA most of my life. In 2002, myself and several concerned citizens successfully removed from employment a rogue police force that operated with Gestapo mentality. During the next 3 years, my family and I were harassed constantly, so I was forced to initiate civil litigation. This complaint was finally served in late November 2006, listing the county and tribe as defendants. Prior to that, the rogue cop was hired back again with a specific agenda: deliver a head on a silver platter as acting chief of police. I will have David Lantry on my show shortly. And because this is it, I am doing this, and what I was talking about today was about the veterans, about the answers, about this project that's going to be done entirely by veterans. And they didn't want me to talk about this. They didn't want me to talk about this. They wanted to make fun of me. They wanted to, well, I'm going to put David Lantry's story in the, let's see. Absolutely, RJ. Waking up with RJ. You can promote my shows anywhere you want. You can promote my magazines anywhere you want. The first one's free. It's up on my website. David said he would never survive prison if he had been there with Clay. I didn't have any problems in prison, man. I ran it. I ran the whole fucking farm and Cofield unit. They pulled me out of solitary confinement. when they couldn't figure out how to run the farm, I would put him back out there in the office. I only had to go after one black guy. And he ran into the major's office so the major would save him. Now, if you ever saw Raising Arizona, Nicolas Cage, goes into prison and all these bad guys are glaring at him. When he walks back into their prison, they go, "Oh, hi guys. Hi guys." That was kind of what prison was like for me. I got a lot done. I got a lot done, man. I wrote a bunch of novels in there that'll be going out. And it's novels about our future. It's a novel about our future. What's going to happen when we abolish all the laws against victimless crimes? Starting to happen in Colorado. We just got a few more. We got a few more things. And, WSR, they helped out. He actually sent me a little bit of money one time. Thanks. I appreciate that. And I ain't going to say anything bad about him. I'm not going to go out and try to hurt him. Because I don't give a shit. I don't give a shit. He made his own bed, let him lay in it. I don't care. Won't tune in. Never did listen to anybody else anyway, so it doesn't make a shit to me. But next week I will have David Lantry on, because I'm going to try to help put this whole thing together for veterans, the Green Bank, and give you an idea. If you got an 8,000 square foot living area and it sold for $600,000 including the land, with a standard mortgage of 5% for 30 years, the monthly payments would be $3,220 a month. But if you finance it with the Green Bank of 1% for 60 years, it would only cost $1,108 a month. That's what we're going to try for. And that may not be where that, nothing's locked in stone. We are developing this, and now you got me on the team. I'm part of this. I'll have the people that are talking about banks, I'll have all that on my show this next week. You guys have a great week. I'm out of time. God bless you all. Thanks. Thanks for hanging on through the rough parts. Thank you. and Crusade Radio, I'll be dealing with you direct from now on. You and Blog Talk will be on here. We'll see if we get on any other channels. I'll let you can let people know, you can let these other people know that I am available. I am no longer on Wolf Spirit or the other one, whatever the hell that was, with Chicken Hawk. See ya, guys. God bless you. Have a great weekend. I'm going to have a great one.